have Eline Powell. I get screwed up with the spelling.
You said it brilliantly.
Eline Powell and Alex Roe, they are the stars in a new show about mermaids. But wait, they don't sing, they don't wish for romance. They're predatory and dangerous. Don't believe me? Take a look at this, Siren. Look at it. It takes place right there in a coastal town known for its legend of once being home to the mythical creatures. Eline plays one of them who ends up on shore. Alex, of course, plays a beautiful marine biologist who discovers her. Take a look.
Hey, are you okay? Do you need help?
Well, Alex, luckily you're a marine biologist and know what to do with like a webbed creature that walks on land. First of all, you did dispel the misnomer. You get legs when you walk out of water. So that's the one truth about a mermaid.
I do. It is very painful. I mean, your bones are cracking and flesh gets just, so it's not pleasant. But yes, that is one of the myths where we're approaching.
So let's start with this. You're not like Ariel from The Little Mermaid.
No.
You're a nasty, nasty mermaid.
Yes.
But there's a reason why you've come to land to this cute little town of Bristol Cove.
Yes, I'd say, you know, these mermaids definitely don't want to be part of your world. Nice.
I caught that.
Thanks.
I'm a mom.
I think they definitely would not want to have anything to do with humans for reasons you'll find out in the show. But she has to because her sister gets kidnapped. So Rin comes on land with a mission. And even though she's very hostile towards humans, she has to rely on some of them to help her because she doesn't know this world.
Well, she doesn't know the language, she doesn't know the people. And that brings where you come in. You play the marine biologist, but the reason why your sister got captured is because of she got fished off into the sea and she got caught in a net. And this brings up your kind of role into like the overfishing of the area.
Yeah, so the reason why the mermaids are actually coming closer to shore are because there's a lot of overfishing going on. So they're being drawn closer and closer, and it's kind of a little bit of a comment on what we're kind of how we're treating our oceans a little bit. But then my character finds this like young feral kind of looking girl and thinks initially that maybe she's on drugs or something, and then when he gets her back, she ends up jumping into the water and turning into a mermaid and attacking him actually. So he's quite nice to her.
Well, you like girls. They play hard to get.
Yeah, exactly.
Very hard to get.
That's part of what drew me to the character as well, as far as this whole idea, the idea of the juxtaposition of mermaids kind of being this beautiful, alluring creature, but then also being incredibly dangerous.
Well, you bring up the interesting point. You guys tackle a couple subjects in here. You tackle the environment through the overfishing, and that's why these mermaids, for lack of a better word, are pissed off.
Yes.
Because
they
can't eat, they're hungry.
Exactly.
And second of all, you want to dispel the myths of mermaids, and especially, like I said, that the way the mermaid looks is not your typical mermaid.
It's not your typical mermaid. In fact, if you got to look quite closely to a still of it, the whole body is unified. It's not so much human skin and scales and then shells and flowing hair. It's much more a unified, unique skin. And then webbed hands, like the whole body's more designed for aquatic life.
And like
she's
a predator.
Back spine, yeah.
She's an apex predator in the ocean.
We are
so
top
she's
level
equipped.
In the ocean.
So
I love how you talk about this like this is fact, that you're a top level predator in the ocean. But really quickly, it brings up the question of sexuality. Like, are mermaids female or male?
I think that's a great question. I actually wonder if Rin is thinking in terms of gender of herself. Definitely not in terms of humans. I think so far we consider her definitely female. But for instance, on land, she doesn't really see male or female. She doesn't see gender, race. She just sees people, and she finds a connection or not a connection. And
is there love in here, you two?
On set, we love each other.
Well,
our intrigue grows. We both rely on each other to achieve an objective. And with that comes trust. And with trust comes walking a mile in each other's shoes, or fins, in my case.
You know what you guys did here? You know how Jaws made us scared to go in the water?
Yeah.
Are we going to be scared to go in the water because of Siren?
After watching this, I think maybe for a little bit. Yeah.
I think you'd think twice before throwing like a plastic cup somewhere in the ocean.
Good point. And I only like happy mermaids, but I want to see you attack him. All yes. right, the 2-hour premiere of Siren is tomorrow night on Freeform. Thanks, guys.
Thank you for being here.
Thanks for having
Very
us.
Very cool. It's going to be an interesting show. I could look at you. You are devilish. You mean mermaid.
That's how I walk into Starbucks.